Kimelev put that shot on behind the net. Yuri Kimelev hasn't played much tonight. Maybe he's part of the checking squad for the Soviets. Yuri knocks it down. Yuri's got Lemieux with him. That's Lemieux. He got it! Mario Lemieux gets the goal, and Pittsburgh takes a 1-0 lead.
Well, you could see as soon as Airy got over the blue line, even though it was a 2-on-1, that his main objective was to pass the puck to Mario Lemieux. There was no way that he was going to go in and try to do anything. You notice as he goes across the red line, he turns his body right away over to Mario Lemieux, and he was going to give him the puck, and he gave it to him so that Mario could shoot the puck on the fly. And although it wasn't one of Lemieux's best shots, the puck was rolling when he did slap it, and I think that it did dip a little on Milnikov, and it was able to slip under his glove.
So the Pittsburgh captain gets the goal. Mario Lemieux, Airy gets the assist, 15:27 the time of it, and it is 1-0 Pittsburgh. They get on the board. With Rome looking, Hannon's in the middle, dropped it back to the point. Right down, straight through the middle, he found Steve Dykstra, even though he didn't get the shot off. Lemieux saw him.
Well, Lemieux was right there.
In front, shot, score! 2-0, tipped in, John Cullen.
Well, what happened on this play is while Mario Lemieux is standing in front of the net, he draws one of the defensemen toward him. And Quinn saw Cullen standing alone to the left of Milnikov, and he was able to put the puck in off the post. The play starts behind the net, and Quinn takes the puck away from the defenseman. Lemieux draws the other defenseman out towards him, and Cullen is standing all alone out in front. A nice backhand pass by Quinn, and Milnikov, because of the speed at which the loss of the puck happened behind the net, wasn't able to recover in time.
John Cullen, the rookie, 6 goals on the season with 24 assists to it. It is a 2-0 Pittsburgh lead, and they are on the power play. Power play that's second best in the National Hockey League. 26% effective. Lemieux just playing pass here along the point with Jim Johnson. He takes the shot. Score! Rob Brown at the side of the net, but I don't think he touched it. Maybe he did. It's Lemieux or Brown, but it's a power play, and it's 3-0 Pittsburgh.
Well, Brown certainly reacted as if he did touch that puck, and all the Soviet eyes were on Johnson and Lemieux, who were passing the puck back and forth at the blue line and on the left side boards. And I think it was the fourth time Lemieux got the puck, he decided to unload, and at that time Brown was all alone to the right of Milnikov, and he was able just to get his stick down and deflect that puck up into the Soviet net.
Their leading power play goal scorer, 17 on the season, second to Lemieux with 13. Rob Brown, credited with a power play goal, as he did tip that one in. And the Central Red Army team will try and get right back into it. Pittsburgh in the second period showed a lot of physical play. Let's see if they continue it here. Gord Dineen got it around and out to Lemieux. Lemieux coming at a 3-on-2 chance right here. This is Airy. Bob Airy all the way in. Scores! Bob Airy, same thing. He picked the left side. And the first shot in the series against Golshimov is a goal.
What a shot by Airy. What happened when the Penguins came across the blue line, the Russian defenseman really was playing Lemieux. You see Lemieux give the puck, and the defenseman is leaning towards Lemieux. He gives Airy the shot, and Airy, there's no doubt about where he was putting it. He had a little space up to the left of the goalie, and he just blasted it up there. When you're able to take a slap shot from that close in, that's because you've been given a lot of room, and that's exactly what happened on that play.
Bob Airy is the fourth leading scorer for this team on the season with 15 goals and 19 assists. And Airy, this season, playing at a plus 25.